Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Cancer the Crab is a constellation of the zodiac. So the sun, moon, and planets all pass through its stars at some point throughout the months and years. However, that doesn't mean it's a bright constellation. Last week we learned that Earthlings are looking up and out of the Milky Way in the coming months, so there aren't as many bright stars to see at this time of year. However, with spring here, we'll eventually have swarms of bees. And this week we'll look for the Beehive Cluster that is located in Cancer. Let's start by getting familiar with this part of the sky. The bright stars of winter are off towards the southwest. Orion is sinking towards the horizon at 3 hours after sunset. To his east is the brightest star after the sun, Sirius. Above that is the first magnitude Procyon, and further up from it are the twins, Pollux and Castor. Between those stars and the orange-red star Betelgeuse in Orion is the brilliant Jupiter. You can't miss it. Jove will be the brightest point of light in the sky here, outshining even Sirius. Now draw a long, imaginary line towards the east from Jupiter, along the line of the ecliptic, which follows the zodiac constellations. Trace the ecliptic by holding up two outstretched arms with your hands like this, measuring approximately 45 or 50 degrees to find the star Regulus. You found this first magnitude star when you see a sickle shape, or backwards question mark. In the world's highly light-polluted locations, the top side of the sickle may be invisible, and some of the third magnitude stars difficult to see. Use binoculars to locate them. So if Gemini and Leo are both zodiac constellations, what do we skip on our way there in that blank-looking section of the sky? Well, Cancer the Crab, of course. Don't buzz away just yet. The Beehive is next. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. A sunset glow has redshifted light. This helps your body recognize nighttime coming. But computer screens have blue-shifted light, so download the free program Flux to automatically change your computer screen every day to redshifted light when the light outside does, at sunset. Now let's use binoculars. The stars get faint here, but with binoculars even from light-polluted areas, stars as faint as 5th, 6th, and 7th magnitude are visible. Start at Regulus and follow the sickle shape up and around. Look at 3.4 magnitude Zeta Leonis. This star is a neat sight. 2 6 magnitude stars are on either side of it. Now turn to the west and go a full field of view to Epsilon Leonis. This line, Zeta to Epsilon, is the general direction we want to go. With Epsilon centered, move ever so slightly in that same direction. You'll see 4th magnitude Alterf now at the edge of your field. In fact, it may be there with Epsilon centered. Now, center that star and keep going. Before Alterf leaves the field, you'll see 5.2 magnitude Xi Cancri enter the field. It will be a magnitude fainter than Alterf. 6th magnitude 79 Cancri is right next to it. Now continue until you see two 4th magnitude stars. The northern one, Acellus Borealis, is 4.7 magnitude and fainter. The southern one, Acellus Australis, is brighter at magnitude 4.0, similar to what Alterf was. But what lies in between them is what's magnificent. You've just found where the beehive is. Sometimes it's also known as the Praecipi, or a Latin word for manger. Now this cluster is huge. It spans 95 arc minutes of sky, which is 3 full moon diameters across. So it's too large to see except in very rich field telescopes with expansive apparent fields of view eyepieces. This means binoculars really are best to use here. The beehive contains around 1,000 stars, though you're likely to spot the brightest 6th to 8th magnitude ones with binoculars for most areas. For more information, visit eyesonthesky.com. Mars is starting to gain some separation from Spica, but remains within 5 degrees of the star. Nearing opposition, check out the red planet now while it's larger than 14 arc seconds across. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.